Yeah, so first thing is the mean. For doing the mean, the score should be a it should be a it's a checking the center, then it's checking the called continuous data. So I hope you understand continuous. So when the data is continuous data, particularly the continuous represent interval or ratio. If the data set is interval or ratio only, you can do a mean. And suppose you are type giving us a categorical data. When we can do the categorical data, suppose if the data is categorical nature. So categorical means like what is it? The first one is a nominal or ordinal. If nominal or ordinal, we can go with the frequency. Frequencies differ. Number of male, number of female, number of literate, number of illiterate. So that is differ. For this case, it's checking only the it's not center, it's not the distributions. It is only checking the percentage. Normally we are checking the percentage based or the number based or count based. We can use this terms. This is for the count, number of people. It's checking the count only, it's checking the percentage only. Therefore, it's called categorical. I hope now you understand the mean difference between the mean as well as the frequency. For checking the mean, the data should be a continuous. Don't think that it's like a category. So see here, you are checking that the 82 is a categorical, 93 is a categorical, 91 is a categorical. So it may be a E score, it may be a single unit. But in the case of the summary, the scores, it may goes with 58 to 100. So because the scores lies in between 58 to 100, there is a band it comes. There is a band. I already mentioned that in the case of continuous data, this kind of band, this kind of interval is needed as well as the magnitude. It satisfies the magnitude value as well as the interval. Therefore, it may call as a continuous data. For applying the mean, the continuous data should be, the data should be continuous. So now I come to the median. Please kindly tell what is that? What kind of statistics? What kind of statistics? Median. It's a center statistics or a deviation statistics? Can you tell the answer? Can you type in the chat box? Exactly. What about the data set? What about the data set? Saraja, correct. What about the Aparna Suresh? What about the data set? What about the data set? What about the data sets of the median? The data set should be a categorical or continuous? Categorical or continuous? Categorical or continuous? Yeah, exactly, continuous. So exactly, the Saraj Joseph is correct. Aparna is correct. It should be a continuous. These are the basic things we have to know. This is the biggest problem for the researcher. Without only they are adopting all the statistics. Okay. So now the next thing, I'm moving to the standard deviation, SD. So SD, where it comes? What kind of statistics? It's measuring the standard deviation. For what purpose we are checking? We are checking the dispersion. Exactly. So for checking the dispersions, what kind of data sets we can use it? So for checking, yeah, exactly, Surabhi is correct. It's also continuous. I hope now you understand. So for checking the mean, median, standard deviations, these things is needed. If you go with the quarter deviation also, the same thing. But I'm going to skewness. Yes. So skewness, for what purpose we are checking the skewness? For what is the purpose we are checking this skewness? So from the skewness, what we are going to come for conclusions? We are come for the conclusion about the shapes of the distributions. That is nothing but normality or not normality. What kind of data should need to do a normality analysis? Please kindly tell the answer. What kind of statistics is needed? Sorry, what kind of data sets we need to adopt a skewness? We adopt a skewness. So once again, it should be a continuous because it's a sampling distribution. For doing a sampling distributions, the data sets also should be continuous. The same thing, what about kurtosis? Whatever the cutoff is, this also shapes, it mentioned the shapes, it's also need a continuous. It's also need the continuous. And one more thing I'm going to check, I'm going to keep like a minimum score, minimum. What is the minimum score? Minimum maximum, I'm going with minimum maximum score, like upper score or lower score. There's a minimum. So it checks in the extremes, it check the extremes only, right? It's checking the extremes of the score. So the same thing, the third question, we are getting the answer now. So the third question, center spread out, then extremes. Yeah, the same thing, extremes. The extremes. Yeah, the same thing only here after checking. The data set should be continuous. The data should be continuous. Yeah, so this is the basic assumptions we have to do. Can we do a frequency for this data sets? Kindly tell. Please, anyone can tell. Can we do a frequency analysis for this data sets? Because we have the data sets, the scores, only one scores. Okay, only one variables. Can we do a frequency? Anyone can give the answer. Can we do a frequency? Is it possible to do a frequency? Is it possible to do a frequency? Yes. How? How? Any idea? How? Because here we could not be divided into male and female. Here the scores are 58 to 100. So we are able to do a frequency analysis only in the case of how many 52s are there. For example, I'm going like this, 58 to 100, sorry, 58 to 68. Then otherwise, I'm going like this, 50 to 60, 50 to 60, 51 to 60, then 61 to 70, 71 to 80. 81 to 90. So like that, if you're dividing this course into some kind of band, then you can check how many, I'm going to check 51 to 1, 2, only two scores, 51 to 60. Then 61 to 70, I'm going to check 61, 1, 2, only two. Then 71 to 80, so I'm checking 71 to 80, 1, 2, so only two. Then 81 to 90, 1, 2, only 2 is there. Okay, so like that you can check the numbers of 51 to 60. So only this way we can do a frequency. But in the case of the descriptive statistics, so we could not be find directly frequency with the use of the analysis tool pack. In the analysis tool packs, it gives the answer only for this area only, this rectangular bar, mean, median, standard deviations, skewness, cutoff, minimum and maximum. So if you want to know the frequency, like number of male or number of female, if you divide the group into two groups, like see here, I'm going to show the other data sets. Like see here, there is a male group as well as the female group. I have the two variables, male achievement score, female achievement score. There we can check how many males are there, how many females are there. In this case, we can use the frequency, but only the thing, the frequency, we need two categorical data. Therefore, what's the category king here? Male is a category, female is a category. Then only we can do this kind of frequency analysis. So the people are having the raw assumption that particularly while using the SPSS, if you click anything, the answer may come. Some people are doing categorical data for the mean analysis. Only the classification 1 and 2 only, but they're checking the mean scores of the 1 and 2 scores. So it's totally unfair. So be cautious. Whenever you're doing a statistics, kindly check the basic assumption to do your statistics. Then only you can lead further. Okay. Now I'm going to do a statistics through Excel. For doing a Excel statistic, go with the data first. Please kindly check the data path. Kindly check the data path. Click the data. After clicking the data, you are finding the data analysis tool pack. So when you are getting this tool pack, in the sense, once you install it through the add-in, then only you are able to see this one. Now I'm clicking the add-in options. Once you click the add-in options, now you are getting the lot of features of these statistics. See here, Now my intention, I have to do a descriptive. Please kindly check what is the terms more apt for the descriptive, whether any terms you are finding as a descriptive here. Kindly check, did you found any terms related to the descriptives in this box in the data analysis tool pack? Kindly type. So a lot of terms are raised there. ANOVA, ANOVA two-factor, ANOVA two-factor without replications, correlation, covariance, descriptive, exponential, F-test, Fourier analysis, histogram, random number, rank and percentage, regression, sampling, t-test, there is a three t-test, that is a test. Yeah, exactly. There is a terms here represent descriptive. Kindly select this one and click OK. Please kindly see here. Once I can do the demonstrations, first you have to open the data sets. First you have to open the data set which you are going to do a descriptive analysis. After opening the data sets, go to the data, then go with the data analysis. In the data analysis, you are going to click the descriptive statistics and click OK. So you are getting this kind of descriptive statistics window. Their input, what is my input range? So what is my input range is nothing but my variable. What is my variable in this case? Kindly type someone's. What is my variable? How many variables I have in this case? How many variables I have in this particular table, in this sheets? Only one column. Therefore, Amrita KP, column is correct answer. Madam Twinkly Wilson, that is 14 is a sample. 14 is a sample. Okay, I'm talking about the scores only. So how many variables? I already mentioned that column represents a variable, row represents a sample. In this case, input range is our 14 sample scores. But how many variables? How many variables? How many variables we have? Anyone? How many is we have only one variable, that is nothing but our scores. Okay, what you have to do, keep the cursor, see here, keep the cursor in the input range and select this course. I'm selecting the scores from the heading onwards. I'm selecting scores, it means that A1 to A15. I'm selecting A1 to A15. The scores, the heading also is selected. Then after this, there is an option called labels in first row, because I am adding the scores heading also here. Therefore, what I'm going to do, so see here, immediately the changes happen. Just I'm doing once again, keep the cursor in the input range and select this course. Then after that, select the label in first row, because you're selecting the label in the first row. Now I already give the input. I want to get the output as a result of the descriptive statistic. What I'm going to do, I'm selecting the output range. I'm keeping the cursor in the output range. I'm keeping the cursor in the output range. I am selecting one empty spaces. See here, I'm selecting the spaces of E15. So I am selecting one spaces. Then immediately there is a E15 output ranges shows here. After this, click the summary statistics, because I need a summary statistics. So what I'm going to get summary statistics only. Therefore, I'm clicking the summary statistics. It's nothing but a descriptive. Click OK. Once I click OK, I'm getting this much of answers. Kindly check. So how many of them got the same answer? Very simple. Okay. But if you want to check the mean, we have to do normally in the formula options, separate mean formula, then standard error, standard median, mode. We have to do one by one in the case of the formula base. Suppose if you want to do your formula base, you have to go with more function, go with statistics. First, you have to go with average. Then after that, you can go for the standard error. So a lot of processes are available. But in the single click, I'm getting this much of options, this much of answers, right? So how many of them got the same responses, same answers? Those who are doing along with me, you may get the same responses, same answers. So very simple way, I'm generating the descriptive statistics answer. Now I'm going to write the interpretations. Just so you can tell, what is it by mean? What is it represent mean? What is represent mean? Can you tell anyone's give the answer? What is represent mean? Mean is nothing but average. Okay, so it means that the average course of the 14 student, the average course of the 14 student is 81.21. Okay, What is my standard error? Anyone can define what is my standard error? What is my standard error? If you look onto the Google, you are getting the definition is called a standard deviation of the sampling distribution. Standard deviation of the sampling distribution is called as a standard error. Normally, the formula for standard error is equal to sigma divided by root of n. So, deviation divided by root n, you get the answer is called standard error. But generally speaking, standard error means the difference between the means of the sample and means of the population. This is some kind of error may happen between the sampling error as well as the population error, population mean. The difference between the population mean as well as the sampling mean, the difference is called, we may treat it as a standard error normally. In this case, the standard is 4.05. Then median, what is my median? What is my median? Middle value. So out of this much of score, the middle scores is 85. Then the mode is the most frequent value. Most frequent value is called mode. Most frequent value is called mode. Okay. What is my standard deviation? Any idea what is the standard deviation? What is my standard deviation? Standard deviation of the scores. Standard deviation of the scores from the mean. Normally we are reaching this term. How much standardly the scores are deviated from the mean. That is called standard. It means that what is the standard deviation? I will tell the answer. So what is the standard deviation represent? We already know the mean score is 81.21. Okay, that is our mean score. Just I'm doing the 81.21. Now this is a mean score. So the standard deviation represent what in the sense? Just I will yes. So here what is our standard deviation? Our SD is equal to 15.13. So what it means? What is it exactly standard deviation and mean represent? That's I will do with some examples here. It means that the scores are deviated from the left side and right side 15.13. For example, there is a score 81.21. So what I'm going to do now is equal to this score, mean score minus standard deviation. What is my standard deviation? 15.13. So 66. Then mean plus standard deviation is equal to mean plus standard deviation 15. So what it means? My scores, see here, this is scores. The scores deviations, the standardly deviated scores from 66 to 96. So I'm going to make it as a green color mark, then you can understand. Okay. So the standard deviation represent this only. So what is my standard deviations? My mean scores are 81.21. It means my scores are deviated, the left side 15.13, the right side 15.13. It means that the standardly the scores are deviation from 66.08 to 96.03. This is called standard deviation. I hope now you understand. How many of them got the meaning of standard deviation? Can you type in the chat box? What is my standard deviation exactly in the sense? How these scores are standardly deviated from the mean scores? So in this case, mean is 81, standard deviation 15.13. Therefore, we have to go with the formula is mean minus standard deviation. In this case, this is called mean plus standard deviation. This is a formula based only. We may get the answers. Normally, when you go for the some kind of levels like a low, moderate, high, suppose if you want to do some kind of percentage analysis to checking the attitude or the interest, how many people are low attitude, low interest. So you have to go with this kind of statistics measurement like mean plus or minus standard deviation formula. Similarly, the next is called sample variance. I hope you're already familiar with the understanding the relationship between the standard deviation and sample variance. Standard deviation square, the square of standard deviation is called sample variance. In this case, see here, my standard deviation is 15.13. If you square 15.13 into 15.13, you are getting the answer 229.19. The same thing I am going to do see here is equal to, I am selecting the standard deviation and I am multiplying once again standard deviations. I am multiplying once again standard deviation. So is equal to 209.106, the same answer. Same answer. Okay. Now in the case of cutoffs, is checking the height only. It's checking the height of the normal pulp, it's checking the height of the distributions. In this case, -1.46. Therefore, whether it's a leptokurtosis or a mesokurtosis or platykurtosis, can you tell what is that conclusion we may come for this? Is a leptokurtosis or the platy? I already mentioned that if the score is plus or minus 1, we may treat it as a mesokurtosis. If above the point plus 1 is called as a lepto, less than the minus 1, we can use the term as a platy. Therefore, in this case, it's called a platykurtosis. Platykurtosis. Yes. In the case of skewness, I already mentioned that the skewness value is 0. It's called skewness. It means symmetric. In the case of psychometric, we can add up the plus or minus ratio also the skewness value. Okay. So in this case, the skewness value is very near to the 0. Therefore, we may treat it as a NPC, normal public curve. Therefore, the skewness is represented symmetric. Therefore, the distributions may come at the symmetric nature. Symmetric nature. Symmetric nature, right? The range, we already know the formula for range is called highest score minus lowest score. So it's nothing but minimum score minus maximum score. It's already there. See this case, 100 minus 58. The maximum score minus minimum score is equal to 42. That is called range. And then you know the minimum score, maximum score. What is the sum? Sum represent the entire score addition. For example, if you want to sum additions, add all the scores. All the scores. So how we can add all the scores? In this case, I'm going to add all the scores is equal to sum of, it's a formula, normal formula I'm using, sum of all this 14 scores and enter it, you are getting the 1137. The count is nothing but number of samples. So that is called frequency. So she's telling us the frequency. But the case of frequency, I already mentioned that. So here, each row is treated as a category. Each row is treated as a category. It's nothing but N. So here, the count is nothing but N. It's not a frequency. It represents the N, exactly represents the N, number of samples only. Therefore, it comes 14. I hope you don't have any doubts in this. If you have any doubts in the descriptive statistics, you can ask me. Very simple way. I'm giving the interpretation also. What is the average? What is the standard error? What is the median? Please kindly ask your questions now if you have any queries. So if you're okay, can you move to the next level? Yeah, so Vibin Jai, thank you. Thank you, Surabhi. Thank you, Amada. Vishnu. Okay. Okay. Now I am going to the data sets of two. I'm opening the data set one. See here, I'm opening the data set one. Why I'm giving the answer in the sense while doing yourself alone, you want to crack check whether you did properly. For that, I'm keeping the answer also for your purpose, for easy to understand. I'm keeping everywhere is an answer also. So for easy to crack check whether the way of working from your end is to be correct or not, because most of the people are attending through mobile phone only, you are not able to do parallel along with me. That's why I'm keeping answer along with the e-sheets. You can do later and check whether the same answers comes to your end. Yes, now see here, I'm having the data sets, the serial number and the two groups, male and female. So it's nothing but male group achievement score, female group achievement score. Now I have to ask the question to all. How many variables I have? Kindly check how many variables I have. In this data sets, please kindly check. Yeah, Surabhi, Mohanan, correct, exactly. The two variables are there. What is my variable? What is my variable? Male is one variable, male achievement score. The other one is a female achievement score, right? Can we do a descriptive once again for this data? But I'm going to do separately. I'm going to do separately for the male and female, and I'm going to tell all together also. First, I'm going to do alone for doing the male only. So please kindly tell anyone, kindly unmute and tell me the path to do a descriptive statistics. Please kindly, anyone can unmute. Anyone can unmute and then talk to me. Anyone. You can direct me, I can do from my end, because you're already familiar with how to do a descriptive. Now you have to tell the path I have to do based on your directions. Anyone kindly unmute. Yeah, Amrita, are you ready, Amrita? So there is a two Amrita is there. Okay. Amrita P or Amrita KP? Anyone? Kindly unmute. Anyone? Why this much of silence? Are you Shruti Sivaraman? Shruti Sivaraman? Please, I don't give any mark for you. Okay, so only today, only my torture. Okay, so tomorrow I won't be making torture to you. Please kindly come forward and give direction for me to do the further calculation.
Sir.
Anyone? Yes, so sir. Yeah. Thank you, Priya. Thank you, Priya KP. Yes, now kindly tell the path.
Sir, first select data.
Yeah, so I am already open the data. Okay, then.
Next, data analysis.
Very good, very good. Then?
Next, addiction. Adding.
So, where I can go? Yes. So, I am starting descriptive statistics. After that, what I have to do?
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. Please. The next, please tell the path.
Input range.
So, kindly tell what is my input range in this? What is my input range? Can you check? A is only the serial number. Whether A is needed?
A2 to 8.
Please kindly see. A is here. A column is represent only the serial number. It's not needed. Okay. Our case, only the male and female one is needed. So kindly, we want to do only the males. Descriptive statistics.
819.
That is not A, that is called B. Please see B. Okay. B. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay.
So I'm keeping the cousin the input range. After this, we have to select the male up to 45, the last score up to 45, right? After this, this okay. Can I click the labels in first row?
Yes, sir.
Why I have to click the labels in first row? What is the reason I'm selecting?
The first row we...
Because in the mail, I'm selecting the mail also. I'm selecting the heading also. That's why exactly. Then what we can do next, output range, keep the cursor and select any empty spaces. Okay, I'm selecting this empty space. That is called H22, okay. Right? Then next, what we have to do? Which one we have to select? So what is the options? Summary statistics.
Summary statistics, sir.
Yeah, exactly. Then click OK.
OK.
Then, so Kankaraj. Okay, Priya. So you did correctly. Yeah. See the answer. This for the male group, 47 male, standard error 3.98, median 44, mode 43, standard deviation 15.44, sample variance 238.52, kurtosis. Now, anyone can tell what is the skewness? What is the skewness value? What is the skewness? It's a NPC or a positive skewness or negative skewness. According to the psychometric. I'm talking about psychometric. So what is the value? The value of skewness. It satisfies the what property? Anyone? Yeah, I already mentioned that in the case of the psychometric, we can adopt the plus or minus one region. So in this case, The kurtosis value is plus or minus 1 only. So therefore, we may treat it as NPC. We can leave the normal public, sorry, we can leave the parameter statistics in future. So the other, if you want to do extension of any statistic, you can go with the normally, in the case of the textbook control, you may find out the answer. Normal public skewness value is equal to 0. It's exactly 0 only. But in this case, for the psychometric purpose, we can adopt the plus or minus 1 region. Now the same thing, the kurtosis. What is the kurtosis value? Anyone can tell what is the answer? I am typing as a measure kurtosis. I already mentioned that the measure kurtosis value is plus or minus one region to be acceptable. Therefore, we may treat it as a measure kurtosis, also NPC only. Yeah, so very good. Thank you, Priya, to give the answer. Apparently, I am going to female also. Kindly check how we can do a female. So I am clicking the data analysis, descriptive statistics, click OK. Now, instead of B1 to B16, I am selecting the entire female. I'm setting the entire female. I'm keeping the output range here, L22, and summary statistics. Click OK. Now we are seeing the female. Now we are seeing the female and female data. All right, so the male data sets, male descriptive as well as female. Suppose you want to do together, instead of here, two times. If we to do together, what we can do? See here, I'm going to do. I am going to here. Previously, I do the two times for male separately, female separately. But instead of the click, you can do for calculation of male and female. I'm clicking once again data analysis and descriptive statistics. Click OK. And I'm selecting input range both. Please kindly see. Previously, we are selecting only the B1 to B16 only, but now I'm going to select all together. See here, B1 to up to B1. I'm selecting both the columns, B and C columns together. Therefore, B1 to C21 together I'm selected. Then the output range I'm selecting L22. This is called L22. Therefore, I'm keeping the output range here. Then summary statistics, click OK. The problem already having some 1 minute. There is an issue in this case because already we have some kind of table is there, no? So that's I delete this one. Okay. Yeah. So now I'm going to generate the answers here. Data analysis, descriptive. Then I'm selecting the output range here, the outside region. Otherwise here. Then click OK. Having trouble for a offset input output range. There is a 1 minute. I am keeping down. Yeah, so input range totally changed. That is issue. So once again, I'm selecting the input range. This is the input range I'm selecting. Then output range N19. Then summary statistics. Click OK. Now you are getting the entire answers. See here. So all together it comes male separately, female separately. Now you can check the both answers same. Male of this is for the male group, this is for the female group. I'm making it two different color. So I enter this is for the male group, this for the female group. Yes. So this way we can do a descriptive statistics.